Now, in this video, we are going to solve one more problem on projections of lines, that is problem number 56, by using AutoCAD software. So it is read as, draw the projections of a line capital PQ and find its apparent length, that is P dash, Q dash and PQ, and true length, that is capital PQ, and true inclination with HP, that is theta. When the line capital PQ has its end capital P is 25 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP, the distance between the end projectors of the line when measured parallel to the line of intersection of HP and VP is 60 mm. The end capital Q is 50 mm above HP and the line inclined at 30 degrees to the VP. So this is the problem. So now we will try to solve this by using AutoCAD software. First, we will go to the AutoCAD screen, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. Now we will go for the command limits. So here, specify lower left corner by default 0, 0, you accept it. Upper right corner by default 12, 9, so you type 297, 210. Then zoom all, then go to line. So select some arbitrary point here and click on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse towards the right side. Take some distance and click on first button of the mouse. Again, you take the cursor to the top side. Take some distance and click on first button of the mouse and then press enter key. Then go to offset. Take the distance as 297. Select this vertical line and offset to the left side. And then again, go to offset. Take the distance as 210. And select this horizontal line and offset to the top side. Then go to zoom, extend. Again, you take zoom command and take 60% of this display screen, then go to fillet, select between this vertical line and this horizontal line, and this vertical line, horizontal line, and this vertical line, and this vertical line, and this horizontal line. So this is how you will be able to write the A4 size sheet. Now we'll go for layer, click on new layer, type the layer by name XY, type the layer by name front view, enter, type the layer. So here I will just delete this layer. Then here I will rename this as front view, then enter, then click on the new layer by name top view TV, then click on the new layer as true length, then click on the new layer as locus, enter. Now layer 0 line weight will be having 0.05 and say okay. The front view line weight will going to be 0.5. Okay. The top view line weight will going to be again 0.5. Okay. Then the true length line weight will going to be 0.3. Okay. Then the locus line will going to have 0.05. Okay. Then the XY line will going to have 0.13. Okay, then we go for the locus line type, click on the continuous, click on load, take the cursor here and type D dash dot and say okay, and click on dash dot and say okay. So once you do that, then we will going to have the true length, we're going to have the color of 30 index color, then the top view will going to have the red color, and the front view will going to have the magenta color. Then you say close. Now we'll go for a line command. Then first we'll going to draw a horizontal line of any distance, and then you take 25 mm above XY line and 20 mm below XY line. So you'll go to offset, you take 25 mm, select object to offset, you select this horizontal line and offset to the top side, and again go to the offset, take the distance as 20, then enter, select this line and offset to the below XY line. Then go to time, type nearest on this, type line, take nearest point on this and take perpendicular to this line, and then go to fillet between this and this, between this and this. So once you do that, then we need to go for offset 50 mm, that is above XY line. So go to offset, take the distance as 50. So from here, you take this to the top side. Then from here, he has given the distance between the end projectors is 60. So then go to offset, take the distance as 60. And so from here you offset to the right side, and then go to extend, select this as the boundary, and also you select this as the boundary, and you extend on these two sides. So once you get this, so then line will be equal to, then is int of this, and now you take intersection point of this. So you'll go to get the front view now. Once you get the front view, you draw an arc and make it parallel, and then extend that line. So to do that, so go to line, so go to circle, take int of this, and take intersection point of this. So once you, now we have rotated that and make it parallel, then go to trim, select between these two, and you trim this portion and also on this portion, and then go to erase this line. So once you do that, then go to fillet between this line and this line, then go to line, take line int of this, and draw perpendicular to this boundary, then go to line, take the true inclination line now. Line int at the rate of 100, I will take some distance less than minus 30 degree because clockwise measurement is negative. So you just draw this line so that it will going to cut this line here. So you go to fillet between these two now, select between these two, so you're going to get this part. Then go to line, take int of this, and draw a horizontal line, and then extend this on this side. So you get this as the locus line. So now we are going to trim, select this as the cutting edge, and this as the object to trim. So then go to line, take int of this, take line, int of this, and take intersection part of this. So now you have the front view and top view. Now from here you draw one more arc so that you make it parallel, and from here you draw a perpendicular to this locus of Q in the front view. So to do that, so first go to circle, take int of this, and take intersection point of this line. Then go to line, circle, take int of this, and take intersection point of this. So once you do that, then go to trim, select between this line and this line, and trim this portion from here and here. Then go to erase this, then go to fillet between this line and this line. Then go to line, take int of this, and take perpendicular to this. So then draw intersection part of this. So now we got the answer, solution we got now. So once you do that, then go to zoom window. Now zoom window, so here line int of this, to take perpendicular to this, and take int of this. So then go to break this line till here, and you break this line till here, and you break this line till here. Similarly, on this side, and now we want to change the layers now. You just click on this, go to layer, you make that layer as XY line, then you escape this, then go to these two and make these two as true length line, go to layer, make that as true length, and switch on the line weight display mode. Then click on this layer, that is layer front view, you make this as the front view, and again you click on this, make this layer as top view, then you click on this and you click on this, and you make that layer as locus layer, and then change the line type scale factor to 10. So once you do that, so this is how you will be able to solve this problem. Now what we need to find out, we need to find out is P dash Q dash PQ now. So to do that, so first I will go for list. List this or inclined line, that is the front view and top view. So front view will be 65, that is P dash Q dash is 65. So you can see P dash Q dash is 65.00. And also then here list. So we go for the top view. The top view is 70.77 or 70.77. Yes. So we have this, then we need to find out the theta. So to find out the theta, we will see now. So first we'll go to DDIM. First we'll go for the dimensioning, then go to modify. So here you make the precision as 0 here and this as 0.00. Then go to text. So here text height is 3. Then text alignment, align with dimension line. Text placement, you make it above. Offset from the dimension line, you make it 2. Then go to symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 3. Then go to lines, take the offset from the origin as 2 and say OK and then close. Now we go for dim. Take intersection point of this and take INT of this. So we're going to get 25. Then go to INT of this and take INT of this. And you're going to get 20. Then nearest point on this and perpendicular to this, you're going to get 60. Then nearest point on this, perpendicular to this, you're going to get 50. Then we have this dimension, that is the true length we need to take. Then go to INT, you switch off this and take INT of this. So here go to text. So type true length equals question mark. So here place it wherever you want. Then go to break this till here. Then we go for dim. I go for angular dimension, select between this line and this line. So you'll go for the text. What is the text? 19.46. You can see 19.46 degree. So that is right. So here give space, enter. So place it wherever you want. So once you do that, now we'll go for M text. Select this and you draw this box. Now you go to M text. You select this as a box. So here go to D text, select this and you mark this as height as 3 and you mark this as X, you mark this as Y, you mark this as VP, you mark this as HP. So here you mark this as capital P in bracket and you mark this as capital Q in bracket. So this will be locus of Q. Then you come down to this and you mark this as capital P in bracket. This will going to be capital Q in bracket. So this will going to be the locus of Q. So here you need to mark this P dash, this as Q dash, this as Q1 dash. This as Q2 dash. And you mark this as Q2 dash and this will be Q1 and this will be Q2 and that will be Q2 dash and this will be small p. Now you go to DD edit, you just come down to this, go to move, you make this as Q1, you bring this Q1 dash here. So this will be Q1, this will be D text. So here you mark this as small q. Now you just go to move. So go to X and you mark this as Y. Similarly VP and then HP. Then you have P and you have capital P. Then you have P dash. Then you have capital P here, then you have Q dash, and then you have Q2 dash, then you have small q, then you have capital Q, then we have locus of Q, then you have Q2, then you have small q, then Q1, then you have capital Q, then you have locus of Q. Then go to M text. So you take this and you mark this point. So you go to formatting, go to symbol, select this, and you give small q, which is theta. Now we need to write the directions of projections. So here, this is the direction of projection. So to do that, line leader, take nearest and draw tangentially to this arc, annotation option none. Similarly, leader, take nearest of this and draw tangentially to that arc, annotation option none. Then go to ortho mode, then go to leader, take nearest on this side, and you drag this, annotation option none. Then go to leader, nearest on this side, and take annotation option none. Then go to explode this and this. Then go to erase this line and this line. Similarly, erase between these two. So once you get this, so you have all these things has been done. So then go to vertical plane, P dash, Q dash, Q2 dash, locus of Q, and here Q1 dash, and select that layer as front view. Similarly, HP, small p, Q2, Q, Q1, locus of Q. Then go to layer, make that layer as top view. Then you click on both P's, both capital P, and here both capital Q. Then go to color and change that color to blue. So once you do that, now we are going to write the answer. So dtext, you put up the caps lock on and then go to type answers. Now here you type first the true length, TL. Then here, what is the length of the true length? The true length will be 75.05 mm. Type 75.05, give, remove that. Then go to move, switch off this. So place it wherever you want. Then go to ortho mode, you draw a horizontal line and then you extend this here. Then go to line, take end point of this. And then go to line, take nearest point on this and draw a horizontal line. Then go to offset, take the distance as 6. Then go to trim, select this as the cutting edge and this as the, then copy, select this and select this, copy this to the next and here also and here also. Then go to erase, erase this, then come down to this, then go to copy, select this and you copy this theta here. Then the angle theta should be 19.46, then go to DD edit. So 19.46 degrees, 19.46 %d. So we're going to get degree symbol. Then we need to have P dash Q dash. So here P dash Q dash, and sorry, and then here you will going to have PQ. Then the length of this line is 65.0 mm. So here you take 65.00, enter, and P dash Q dash, which is 70.77. So you go to this and you mark this as 70.77. So this is how you will be able to solve the problem by using AutoCAD software. And both this and this are exactly similar. And this is our final solution for this particular problem. Then thank you.